So let us look at one more example program in Java with BlueJ for ICSE class 10th. This is chapter number 3 and we are looking at the examples of double dimensional arrays. So today's program is write a program to create a 3x3 square matrix and store numbers in it. Check whether the matrix is symmetric or not. So let us first understand what is a symmetric matrix. A symmetric matrix is one in which the element of Aij will be equal to the element of Aji. A is any integer matrix, I is the row number, J is the column number. Let us look at a practical example. This is a 3x3 matrix, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 5, 3, 5, 6. First row, first column. First row, second column. Second row, first column. First row, third column. Third row, first column. So, if you interchange the numbers of column and row, then element at that location should be equal. Look at this example. This is second row, third column. If you interchange it, it will be third row, second column. This is third row, this is second column. So this will be called a symmetric matrix. So we need to create a 3x3 matrix and ask the user to enter numbers in it. For that we are going to use the scanner class. For that we will be using the utility package. So first import java.util.star. Then create a scanner object. Scanner x is equal to new scanner system.in. We will require three integer variables I, j and k. We will initialize k to 0. We will need only one integer double dimensional array. Integer m bracket bracket equals to new int 3 3. This will create a double dimensional integer array named m. After that we can fill the array with numbers. We will ask the user with a output statement here, and then we will accept the numbers using this statement mij is equal to x dot next int. X is the scanner object, next int is the method in the scanner class. This array will hold 9 numbers 3x3. Once the numbers are entered, we can display the matrix using the same nested for loop, system.out.print mij plus space. Once you display the numbers in the matrix form, then we'll check whether the matrix, the numbers entered form a symmetric matrix or not. So for that, we'll use the nested for loop. For I is equal to 0, I is less than 3, I double plus. For j is equal to 0, j is less than 3, j double plus. If mij is not equal to mji, we will go through the loop for every number or every location in the array, and we will check if the number at location mij is not equal to mji. We have used the integer variable named k and we have initialized it to 0. So initially k will be 0, but if the given array is not a symmetric matrix, then k will become 1. We will compare the numbers of mij with mji, and if they are found not to be equal, then it will not be a symmetric array. That time we will change the number of k from 0 to 1 and then we can display the result. If k is equal to 0, then it is a symmetric matrix, else it is not a symmetric matrix. So it's a simple program. We will run this program in the BlueJ compiler and see how it works. You will also find this program in the comments box. So this is the program. Let us now check the program. Class, save, compile. Right click on the programs icon and select void main string arguments. Press OK. Enter the numbers of the matrix. So as we know, we need to check whether the given matrix is symmetric or not. So first we will enter the numbers of a symmetric matrix from our example. 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 5, 3, 5, 6. So this is the symmetric matrix from our example. So the program immediately recognizes it as a symmetric matrix. Now let us run this program to enter a different set of numbers. This time I will enter a non-symmetric values. So as you can see, it is immediately recognizing as it is not a symmetric matrix. So you can test this program with different set of values and see how it works.